indicate, signify by saying aye. Any opposed?
Nay.
Yeah, I passes four, two, three. The next one is E60, a personal services agreement between the county of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Nassau County Attorney's Office and Natalie Osgoven, PLLC. Motion, please. Move by legislator Nicolau, second by legislator Osgoven.
Gerald Pappas, Deputy County Attorney. This is for an affirmative litigation matter suing the, for potential litigation against manufacturers and distributors of prescription opiates.
Yes, and our leader, Devon.
Hey, Jerry, how are you?
I'm good.
On the, I'm sure you're aware, on the disclosure form, the partner Hunter J. Shkolnik, am I pronouncing that correctly?
I would imagine Skolnik.
Skolnik. He indicated on the principal questionnaire, question 13, that he was convicted of a past tax, five-year tax year, failing to file any required tax returns or pay, or failed to pay any of the applicable federal, state, or local taxes or other assessed charges, including but not limited to water and sewer charges. I just want to make sure for the record that the county attorney's office was aware that he had made a yes on this particular form.
County attorney's office is aware of it. He's indicated that he has paid estimated taxes with an extension to file a completed return, and he has paid a significant portion of the tax penalty with the remainder to be paid by March 30th of this year. And we consider this to be a one-time unexpected event.
So, I mean, the county is aware, so did the county inquire as to why the taxes were delayed or performed in any internal evaluation as to how the information could be relevant to the council's competency to the residents of this county, represents this county?
Apparently his previous law firm had closed a recent transaction between him and his firm, and he was assessed on paper for a very large share of the profit that was unexpected and was a one-time event. This required his accountant to reassess his estimated taxes, which turned out to be an insufficient amount, given the unexpected allocation of past profits. He asked his accountant to seek a further extension, and he was to do so, but according to the accountant, it would take long into 2017 to get considered. He has since paid a significant portion of the tax penalty, as I've already indicated. Because apparently there was a snafu involving his former firm, and he has dealt with it.
Two things, Jerry. I mean, in your response, I didn't hear, was there an evaluation done or wasn't there an evaluation done to determine his competency to represent the county?
There was an evaluation.
Oh, there was?
Yes, of course. We do that for every contract that we bring before you.
Is that evaluation, is it written out or is it something verbally done in the office?
It's done verbally, and it's a matter of conferences between attorneys.
Okay, and during those conferences with attorneys and the evaluation, obviously, because this contract is before us, the county attorneys didn't feel that his past discretions or any reflection of his competency to represent the county.
That's correct, sir.
Okay. So then moving forward, can someone, I guess, in your office explain the experiences that his law firm possesses in investigating and bringing up action against manufacturers of prescription opiates?
Certainly. They have been working on this issue for over a year now. They have been investigating potential claims on behalf of both individuals and governmental entities against these pharmaceutical manufacturers and distributors for fraudulent and negligent marketing and distribution of opioid pain medications. They have been working with physicians, pharmacists, and addiction specialists. New York remains one of the hardest hit. The Napoli Skolnik intends on pursuing claims against the largest manufacturers and marketers of opioid pain medication. There's, we can give you the names of some of these if you would like them. I'd rather not read them into the record. They believe that they have claims for deceptive acts and practices, false advertising, public nuisance, fraud, unjust enrichment, and other violations. There are national law firm and 9 offices located across the country, local council relationships in other states. They have undertaken leadership roles in pharmaceutical litigation nationwide. Some examples of the firm's past success include over $800 million recovered from 9/11 Ground Zero workers and $650 million settlement to resolve claims against the manufacturer of the drug Pradaxa. Mr. Napoli has also led litigation against the manufacturer of the diet drug Fenfen, leading to a $22 billion settlement. They are actively litigating opiate addiction litigation on behalf of communities across the country. The firm opiate litigation team is being handled out of their Long Island headquarters as well as their Los Angeles office.
And this, to summarize, so basically any potential lawsuit will be similar to the legal action when the Attorney General is 46 days to the major tobacco industry manufacturers. Is that what we're looking towards?
I think that is a rough comparison, but I think it's as good as we can get at this point.
And what's the timetable for any investigations or any action that are going to take place?
I'm unaware of if there is in fact any timetable. I believe that they're being hired in order to institute this in the most expeditious manner for the benefit of all their clients, including the cabinet.
Well, if you could, just continue to inform the legislature of any regarding investigations or any filings of lawsuits. Please keep us notified.
I will bring that back to the attorney coordinating this matter.
Thank you.
Legislator Capel.
Yes, this is kind of interesting. I'd like to understand it better, please. The damages to the county would be what type of damages would you expect the county to incur specifically by virtue of, what do you say, false advertising?
False advertising was one of them, but...
If you were to construct one or two hypothetical cases to which the behavior in which was something to which you would object, what would those look like? I don't understand what this is about.
I think you're getting beyond my poor capabilities at this point, Mr. Copeland.
Well, I'm just trying to understand what it is that we're approving a contract for. People go out and sue manufacturers, but I'm not sure exactly what it is that we want to sue them for before we're approving a contract. Why are we suing these people? These are FDA-approved drugs. We're not talking about drug dealers. Illegal drugs, illicit drugs, right?
Indeed. Let me cite what they say to us. Their goal is to fully compensate the county for the expenditures and burdens placed on the county due to the actions of the potential defendants.
With all due respect, that doesn't tell me a thing about what it is that they're doing wrong. If we're authorizing someone to go sue these people, why? I'd like to understand why is it that we're suing them. And if we don't understand why, I don't think that you should authorize anyone a lawsuit to proceed. I think that's something that behooves us. It's incumbent on us to know what's going on before we initiate a lawsuit.
I would just, where am I going? I get 3 minutes?
Also, would these things also be the subject of some class action someplace on behalf of the, where is the county being injured?
Well, let's not forget that there are human services costs involved, there are social services costs involved. We're also dealing with the police department. We are also dealing with situations involving ambulances.
And these are capable of being quantified?
The law firm believes that it can. May I just point one thing out to you, sir? This is being taken on at no cost to the county. We are not going out of pocket on this.
I know what a contingency fee is. I'm well aware of that. I understand that.
There are some contingency fees where the costs and the expenses are borne by the client. In this particular one, no costs or expenses are being footed by us.
I am fully in favor of going ahead and suing someone and recovering costs in a case where we believe that someone's done us wrong, someone's actually caused us injury. But I'm not hearing how that happens. That's all. I don't see that we're being told what it is that we're upset about.
Well, this is very similar to the tobacco litigation that the minority leader mentioned before. It's also the societal cost of tobacco. We're talking the societal cost of these opioids, which
so what we're trying to do then is, if somebody's prescribed some kind of medication, we are being asked to inject ourselves between the doctor and the patient and decide whether or not that was justified or whether that's going to cause us. Anyway.
I have a question, Mr. Paul.
Yes, ma'am.
The question is simple this. We have this firm who's going to be investigating the misuse of opiates. In the event that the case has to go to trial, are they willing to go to trial? Yes, of course they are. That's part of the contract.
And it's against pharmaceutical manufacturers and distributors for the fraudulent and negligent marketing and distribution of these medications. We're not talking about something that would not be regular or what one would be considered normal. This is for the over and above and profiteering based on opiate sales.
All right. Okay, I have a request to table. A legislator Capel is making a motion to table the item. Is there a second to that motion? All right. All those in favor of tabling, E58, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
E60, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, the item is tabled.
I would appreciate it if the legislators who have questions direct them to my office.
I think we're all in agreement. Basically, we'd just like to understand it better. What is it that we're upset about?
Mr. Polisak, you're going to send us, we'll send you questions of concern, and you're going to send us back the answers to those questions. Is that correct?
I will see that someone who perhaps has greater knowledge and greater ability to answer
questions. At this point, I think we just tabled this item, and we'll be looking to you for assistance in addressing some of the concerns that we have.
Okay.
Thank you very much. All right, the next item is E64, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Nassau County Department of Social Services, and Bernardio and Company LLP. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Nicolello, second by legislator
Good afternoon, Paul Broderick, Deputy Commissioner, Department of Social Services. The item before you is a contract, no cost renewal for a contract, Bonadeo Group. We provide auditing services to the Department of Social Services. The contract period is from January 1 of this year through the end of this year. As I mentioned, this firm has provided auditing services for the department in the past. Recently, the department re-RFP'd these services and has a new vendor on board. However, they work in conjunction with the OMIG, New York State Office of Medicaid Inspector General, and perform audits at the direction of the OMIG. The OMIG has changed direction a number of times, and they have, Bonadeo Group has one audit outstanding. So right now, they haven't been performing any services as of late, but they have to finish one audit that was started last year. So that is why the department is requesting this no-cost extension. Do you have any questions?
Any questions or comments from the legislators? Any public comment? There being none, all those in favor of E64 signify by saying aye. Any opposed? All right, the item passes 4-3. The next item is E66, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau Act on behalf of the Department of Social Services and Planning and Children's Association. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Cookwell, second by legislator Bolden. Mr.
Broderick, yes. This contract is with the Family and Children's Association for Preventive Services. It is from January 1 of this year through the end of this year. It's December 31st. It's for mandated services, and the contract provides preventive services to prevent out-of-home placement for at-risk youth. Do you have any questions?
Any questions of Mr. Broderick? Any public comment? There being none, all those in favor of E66 signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Aye. The item passes unanimously.
Thank you.
The next item is E67. Hold on a minute, please. The next item is personal services agreement E67, and I'm going to call E71 with that item as well, which is another personal services agreement. E67 is a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau acting on behalf of the Nassau County Board of Elections and Super Express Service Inc., DBA, the moving doctor, and E71. Personal services agreement between the county and Nassau acting on behalf of the Nassau County Board of Elections and All American Grand Lines and Motion, please. Moved by legislator Nicolau, seconded by legislator Oscar. Okay, who's here to speak on these two items? That's E67 and E71.
Hi, I'm Larry Nadelka with the Board of Elections. I just wanted to clarify this first. Neither of these two are personal services agreements. They are competitively bid, competitively sealed open bid contracts. These two resolutions are for renewals of the existing contract that was put in place. The initial paperwork was begun towards the end of last year. The renewal is for January 1st. We have not had any elections yet that would require these movers to transport election machines to and from the polling sites to the Board of Elections. First one that we anticipate is the special in May. This contract renewal will take place and be in effect at that time.
Any questions of the legislators? Bernard
Alito? Hey Larry, how are you?
Good, sir.
Just quick question. In regards to the procurement process, it was handled by your office, not by the county's procurement department?
Correct. Board of Elections handles all of our, we handle all of our own purchasing, we handle all of our own contracts. This is done bipartisanly. From creation to contract. It's done, everything when they come in, they're clocked in, they're sealed with trackable labels. They're locked up into a room that needs two separate keys to open at the same time. So there's no opportunity for anybody to take a peek or mutilate or walk off with any kind of the sealed bids. We take it very seriously. This is a process we've done for many, many years. And as a result of our doing it this way, we've actually found that we've increased the competitiveness of the bids. We actually have a third, even a fourth bidder that came on board with the new system. So we believe that the way we're doing it gives the county a good bang for its buck.
Thank you.
Any other comments or any other questions? Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of E67 and E71 signify by saying aye. Any opposed? My intuition was unanimous. Thank you very much, Board. Right, next item is E68, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Nassau County Attorney's Office of Bartlett, McDonough, and Monahan. LLP. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Nicolau, second by legislator Putel. Mr. Lipson.
Good afternoon again, everyone. This is the second amendment to this contract. Amendment number one was approved by this committee. What this amendment does is extends the time of the contract, and this contract did, the amendment expired on March 1st of this year. It extends the term of the contract and it puts more money into the contract. Bartlett McDonough is handling about six cases for the county. Any questions?
Any questions for Mr. Lipson? Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of E68 signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Item passes 4-3.
Thank you.
Next item is E69, personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of Nassau County Attorney's Office and Rifkin Flather LLC. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Nicolau, seconded by legislator Putel. And we have.
Good afternoon, Deputy County Attorney Robert Marin Jr. on behalf of the County Attorney's Office.
Okay, so please.
Ready?
Yes.
It's an amendment for the existing contract with Rifkin Radler to assist in the ongoing annual income and expense litigation. There's currently money and term left in the contract. This is in anticipation of future costs.
Okay. Legislator Nicolau.
So this is for the income and expense litigation?
Yes.
And the total we're bringing up to is $600,000?
I believe that's correct.
For that, for this one law?
I don't know. I know that Rick Randler is handling several cases, at least four cases at the moment. They are not exclusive to the income and expense litigation. So I don't believe they have four separate contracts. I believe this is just an umbrella, all encompassing, for legal services.
I mean, the backup, it says it's Donald and Norman Boning versus the County of Nassau Department of Assessment. So.
That is the ASI. This specific $155,000 is earmarked for the ongoing ASA litigation.
An enormous amount of money to pay for, some critical importance to the county, but it's just
the fact
that there's been a TRO in place off and on for years is just mind-boggling.
Frustrating is another word.
Yes.
As well.
Thank you. How are you?
How are you, sir?
Good. Could you give us the status of the case?
I don't know how extensive I can get into it since it is ongoing, but from a scheduling standpoint, we are back in court at the end of March. The temporary restraining order is in place, and we hope to have it lifted.
And how much money has the county been billed by Griffin Rowley today?
On this specific case, I'd have to check. I don't know.
Well, I'm assuming that we're increasing the contract, the maximum amount of the contract to $155,000 to $605,000. So I'm assuming they're close to the $455,000.
The amount of work on this case since the filing for the TRO has been astronomical. You know, it's an incredible amount of work that they're putting into it, and it involves court appearances, it involves interviews, it involves document preparation. It's an incredible amount of work.
So, no, I guess what I'm asking is, the legislature is to take action on this contract today to increase the amount by $155,000, but we don't know how much hours have been billed to the county, nor do we know how much the county been billed for?
For the ASA, I don't have that information, but we're bringing it to you while there's still money left and why there's still term left versus bringing it to you after they've done the work, and we need to reimburse them for working in the form. So we're trying to be ahead of the game, which I know is of importance to this body.
While there's still money left?
There's not much.
Well, how much is?
I don't know, but I'm telling you firsthand, they've been working nonstop on this. I've been working with them on this. It's an incredible amount of work.
But what I'm saying is, we don't know how much, but we're saying not much, but we don't know how much.
I don't know how much. I'm sure somebody else.
But no. You said earlier that there's not much left.
Correct.
How do you know that?
Speaking to them.
Oh, that's what they told you. Not much left.
Yeah.
Who's them again? Sorry.
Rifkin Radler.
Oh, Rifkin Radler.
Yeah.
So they're telling us how much we have left to pay them.
That was attorney banter.
Okay. I understand.
We have $79,000 left in their existing contract.
$79,000 left in their existing contract.
Yes.
I guess we can expect this litigation will not be wrapped up soon.
I would love for it to be wrapped up soon, but that's up to the judge.
So, I'm sorry, just one more question, ma'am. So, with the $79,000 that's left and the $155,000 that the contract is being increased by, which brings it up to the maximum amount, will that be enough, or will this legislature anticipate coming back and we'll see if more?
Yeah, it's impossible to answer that. It depends on the judge. Litigation is a beast. You don't know.
Thank you.
Any other comments? Any public comment? Aye, there be none. All those in favor of A69 signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Aye. The item passes 4-3. Moving along to E72. A personal services agreement between the county of Nassau and the Albany Nassau County Office of Human Resources and Health Flex, Inc. Motion approved. Moved by legislator Nicolaro, second by legislator. Okay,
George. Mary Norrie from the County Attorney's Office. I'm joined by two members from the Comptroller's Office, Sergio Blanco and Mike Grunwald. This is a contract, a personal services contract to provide dental insurance to Nassau County full-time employees, part-time benefit eligible employees, as well as their dependents.
Okay. Any questions or comments from the legislators? Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of E72 signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Unanimous, 7-0. Thank you very much. Our next item is E73, personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Nassau County Department of Parks, Recreation, and Museums, and Susan Maxwell. Motion, please, moved by legislator.
Good afternoon, Eileen Creed from the Department of Parks. This is a personal service contract for the Empire Games in the amount of $22,000 funded through the Hotel Motel Tax Grant.
Any questions on the screen from the side? Any public comment? If there be none, all those in favor. E73, signify by saying aye. Any opposed? Unanimous for the next item is E74, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau and acting on behalf of the Nassau County Department of Parks and Recreation and Museums and more advertising agency. Also, please, move on to legislator. And allow us to have the legislator.
I think Creative Department of Parks. This is a contract to provide the development and implementation of a comprehensive purchasing of multimedia forms of media and advertising for the Nassau County Parks Department. The amount of $100,000 funded again through Hotel Motel grant money and the contract has not begun. And it was acquired through a procurement of an RFP last year.
Legislator Nicolau.
Okay, just wanted to confirm, I think you just said it, but the contract has not begun, and he has not, or this agency has not performed any services?
No, not yet.
Thank you.
Other questions or comments? Minority Leader.
If I'm understanding the fact correctly, there are 172 potential proposers that this was sent to, and one proposer responded? Am I understanding that right, Mr. Chris?
172 requested copies of the RFP, correct, and one proposer received and evaluated, was received and evaluated, correct.
Did we take a look at the criteria? Maybe something that the 171 other proposers looked at, that there may be a criteria there that they couldn't meet? It just looks like when you have 172 people requested, it appears that the RFP was narrowly tailored to one particular person.
Yeah, I'm not familiar, but I know that this contract, this is an RFP that was issued in 14 for 3 years, so this is the third time we're coming before you with the same contract.
Oh, I know, it's passed by, I guess,
Previous 2 years.
It passed along majority, minority, 4-3 in the past, that I realized, but I'm just curious, when you have 172 potential proposers, it just looks like it's being tailored for one person, because there may be a clause there that they can't do. I guess what I'm asking is, has your department or the county attorney's office reviewed the RFP to determine or to rule that out?
The criteria, I do remember that we did evaluate very closely, was the savings of going to an individual like this, as opposed to what we were doing in the past, where the Parks Department was going out and purchasing our own media or our own advertising in the papers. So this person who came forward, this company, the reason that I remember being so such a positive thing was mainly because they were able to purchase at such a larger volume and save us money.
And in on April 1 of 2016, this body passed by another 4-3 approval, E-106-16, and in the term of that contract, it was from April 1, 2016 to March 31, 2017, from what our understanding is, to do the same work and the scope under this contract.
Correct.
So are we doing this, does that contract, is that duplicative of what this contract is? How are the two contracts different?
Same contract, we had to renew the term because we ran out of money, so it's a new budget line that we're using for $100,000.
But the term, we didn't run out of the terms, correct? The 31st of March is, let's say, 13th, another 18 days.
In anticipation of getting all the paperwork together, we extended the term and the money together. It's only 18 days, we have the whole summer season to advertise our events.
This council is telling me we should just have them make sure that the appendixes are updated as possible. They're reflected in 2016.
Oh, I see. That must have been an error. They used the same template, didn't update the dates. Let's check.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like the error.
That appendix is an example of what we've done in the past. It's not what we're going to be doing this year. That's why it's got last year's date on it. This is a sample of the type of advertising we did last year.
But the appendix reflects what the contract is for.
Correct, but the dates are going to change. This is the 16 calendar. We haven't even booked the entertainment for 17 yet.
So maybe we should have this stuff re-revised and then it can come back to us in a manner where
we would be late then if we do that, because we have to book the advertising prior.
I understand that, but then it's hard for us to approve an appendix which we believe is part of a contract that's not accurate.
Yeah, it's an appendix as an example of the type of media placement we're going to have during.
As part of an example, you said?
It's a sampling of what we've done in the past, which we'll be doing again now. If we wait till we book the entertainment and then come before you with the exact calendar, we'll miss the cutoff again to be within the term of the contract.
Again, I mean, just for the record, the term of the contract that we approved back on April 1, 2016, was through March 31, 2017. So the language should reflect that it's not overlap. But nothing further, Madam Sanos.
Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of E-74, signify by saying aye. Any opposed?
Nay.
E-75, personal services agreement between the County of Nassau acting on behalf of the Nassau County Department of Parks, Recreation, Museums, and Greater Long Island Running Club. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Nicolelo, second by legislator Nicolelo.
Item 3, Department of Parks. This is a contract with the Greater Long Island Running Club for running races and classroom for coordinating, implementing, conducting races that will supplement our Nassau County Marathon. This contract has already started. It's 14 sessions of races. And 5 of them have already been implemented. Problem of delay was the contract was started in December and the vendor had much difficulty with the paperwork, which was returned many times, as well as our insurance requirements. So I come before you today for a $24,290 contract funded by Hotel Motel. And as I said, it's for Greater Long Island Running Club for track races and classroom workshops prior to the marathon.
Any questions or comments?
Quick question. Thank you, Madam Senator. Is there a fee associated to joining this program?
Is there a fee?
Yes.
Yes.
There is a fee. What's that fee?
The fee is the application fee is through the Greater Long Island Running Club. So this is for their coaching and for their event.
No. How much is the fee?
I'm sorry. I don't know.
Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of 275, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any opposed?
Nay.
Okay. Next item is E-76, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau acting on behalf of the Nassau County Department of Park, Recreation and Museums, and Dover Gourmet Park. Moved by legislator Nicolelo, second by legislator
This is a contract with Dover Gourmet for their services to help supplement and provide catered food and beverages and rental equipment for our Lakeside Theater, Empire Games, and other special events for Nassau County Parks. It's in the amount of $110,000, and it's prior to the season beginning, so none of their services have been provided.
Any questions or comments?
Just a quick question.
Minority Leader.
I guess it's more of a question from Jerry. On the business history form, again, similar to the item that came up earlier, question 13 regarding whether in the past 5 years has the business or its owners or offices or affiliated business been subject of investigation by the government agency. They indicated yes. Just want to make sure that the county attorney's office is aware that they filed yes to make sure that they can still fulfill their obligation to the county.
Yeah, we're aware of it, and we do not believe that it is any hindrance to them performing the contract.
And apparently, were you aware also that the county controller conducted an audit in December of 2016?
Yes, we are.
And the controller found that late payment, failure to remit full license fees, failure to submit documentation of their revenue, failure to complete required capital improvements, etc. Were you aware of that documentation in the controller's report as well?
Yes, we've been working with the controller's office to satisfy that through the vendor.
And you don't believe that any of this would jeopardize their ability to provide quality service and keep up with the agreement?
Correct.
To the county?
Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of E-76, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The item passes 4-3. The next item is E-77, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Department of Social Services and Benzoin Psychological Services, BLLC, motion please. Moved by legislator Nicolelo, seconded by legislator. And we have Mr. Broderick coming up.
Good afternoon. Paul Broderick, Deputy Commissioner, Department of Social Services. The contract before you is between Benzoin Psychological Services and the Department of Social Services to provide psychiatric evaluations, written reports, and court appearances and court testimony. Do you have any questions?
So, Mr. Broderick, any public comment? There being none, all those in favor of E-77, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye.
4-2-3. And the next items are U contracts, U5, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau, acting on behalf of the Nassau County Medical Examiner and David Flynn, DDS. Motion, please. Moved by legislator Capello, seconded by legislator Nicolelo.
Timothy Hahn, Medical Examiner's Office. This is a personal services contract for a forensic odontologist to provide dental identification for those bodies which normal identification means cannot be conducted. The terms of the contract is from April 1st of 2017 to April 1st of 2018.
Any questions of Mr. Hahn? Any public comments? There being none, all those in favor of U5, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The item passes unanimously. The next is U6, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau acting on behalf of the Department of Correction and Tata Massive. Motion, please.
So
moved. Moved by legislator Nicolelo, seconded by legislator Capello, and we have.
Good afternoon, legislatures. Narda Hall Correctional Center. Item U617 is for Taha Masjid. They provide the religious services and counseling to the inmate population of the Nassau County Correctional Center. The New York State Commission of Correction mandates that all inmates have the right to hold any religious belief and requires that the facility permit religious advisors to conduct congregated religious activities at least once per week. The impact is from January through December of 2017 with a budget of $8,400.
Mm-hmm. Any questions from the legislators? Any public comment? There being none, all those in favor of U6, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Yes.
Unanimous? All right, the next one is U7. I'm sorry. I'm going to ask for a motion to untable E-16, a personal services agreement between the County of Nassau acting on behalf of the Department of Social Services and the State Center of Long Island, Inc. Motion, please, to untable.
Untable.
Okay, all right. E-16, tabled the last time. It's now a motion to untable. Moved by legislator Minority Leader Kwan, I seconded by legislator. Okay, all those in favor of untabling E-16, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The item is now untabled. Mr. Broderick, what can you tell us?
Good afternoon, Paul Broderick, Deputy Commissioner, Department of Social Services. The item before you is a contract between Department of Social Services and the Safe Center for Child Abuse and Neglect Services. They coordinate the department's sexual and substance abuse cases. They coordinate efforts between Department of Social Services. Has two units of caseworkers there, work in collaboration with the police department and the district attorney's office to address child abuse and neglect cases. The reason why this was previously at the February 13th rules meeting, and the department had requested to be tabled while we were working with the CSEA. They originally had an objection to the contract, which has subsequently been removed. Do you have any questions?
Any questions for Mr. Brodsky? Any public comment? There being none, all those in favor of E16, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Yes.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Our rules is now in recess, and the other committee is now to get...